quarter. Agric grew by 2.6% during the first half of 2019, a huge deviation from the target of 6.2% during the same period last year. Additionally, the 2019 half-year agriculture sector growth rate was 2.1 percentage points lower than the rate during the same period in 2018. Given that Ghana's agricultural calendar has not changed dramatically over the period, it is therefore surprising that the sector is projected to end the year with 6.9% growth rate. We are growing at 2.1 or 2 point something, and we are projecting to grow at 6.9. We are in the half, at the moment, we have a few months to go. Do you think we'll get there? I don't know how there will be that quantum leap. It is therefore important that the basis for the 6.9 projection is relooked, and then economic policy statement provide cogent reasons for such projections. We should provide realistic projections, because as far as Agric is concerned, we are way off the projection. The performance of the agricultural sector is expected to rest mainly on modernization initiative being implemented during the Planting for Food and Jobs program. In order to put the review of the sector component of the budget statement and economic policy of government for 2020 in a proper perspective, it is important to ask what the main challenges and opportunities are in Ghana's agricultural sector, and whether the proposed budget and economic policy sufficiently addresses them. The challenges relate to three broad areas of productivity, profitability, and sustainability. The main opportunity is the availability of arable land. The budget seeks to address the issue of low productivity, which stems from low levels of agricultural modernization. Through the Planting for Food and Jobs initiative, the main strategy is the use of subsidies. And I think that is something we need to look at. While the use of subsidies for boosting productivity in African and Ghanaian agriculture is not new, it is important not to lose sight of its potential distortionary effects. Also, the subsidy strategy tends to be unsustainable if the fundamental issue of poor investment incentive is not addressed. Why do I say that? You provide subsidies, farmers produce, they want good returns on their investments. But if there's no market, there's no storage, what do you expect? There'll be the disincentive to invest the next time. And that's what we are seeing with rice. A lot of rice being exposed to the vagaries of the weather. I would have thought that we shouldn't be saying we are now constructing or we are in the process of completing storage facilities. Everything should have happened at the same time. Otherwise, every rational farmer would cut back on investment. Some borrow to invest and they can't get their monies back. That will be a major challenge. So I think we shouldn't just focus on fertilizer and other inputs, but also look at the other things that happen, the value chain process, and ensure that they are all addressed. The other challenge I mentioned, the third one, is the agricultural, the sustainability of production system. It is much less focused in the 2020 budget and economic policy statement. It is important to adapt production systems that are environmentally friendly. Such systems should be directly incorporated into the various components of the Planting for Food and Jobs program. Example is to use biotechnologies to enhance production technologies or production outcomes. Finally, in the agricultural sector, I would add that it is an era of Ghana Beyond Aid. In an era of Ghana Beyond Aid, we note that the agricultural sector is still heavily dependent on the magnanimity of donors. Why do we say that? In 2019, at least 55% of allocations to MOFA and fisheries and aquaculture development were expected to come from donors, 55%. If you are married and 55% of your income it should come from your father-in-law or mother-in-law. If you can imagine how you run your home effectively. So I think the share of donor funding is expected to be less in 2020, but still high. Approximately, it's about 40% share of donor funding to agriculture. That is still very high, and I think that is not a good signal. Whether the reduction in the share of donor allocation to the agriculture sector is a sign of a Ghana Beyond Aid or not will be seen in subsequent budgets.